It's AumSum time!
What if banks disappeared?
No problem. AumSum has lots of money.
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this hoodie, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if banks disappeared, there would be severe shortage of cash all around. Secondly, if banks disappeared, people would have to carry their cash everywhere they go. Thirdly, many people keep their gold in bank lockers. If banks disappeared, they may have no idea where to safely store it. Fourthly, many people buy cars by taking loans from banks. If banks disappeared, sale of cars may fall sharply. Lastly, if banks disappear, usage of cryptocurrencies might skyrocket. What if money didn't exist?
Then I will start using my special edition AumSum coins.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, there would be no millionaires or billionaires anymore. Secondly, with no money being offered, people with non-interesting, boring jobs will quit immediately. This can be good for society. Only if, instead of slacking off, people actually start working on their real passion. Thirdly, barter system will be in full swing. Even if there is no money, there will always be some currency. For some, it will be food. For some, it will be tools. For some, paintings, etc. Fourthly, innovation might take a back seat if the primary motivation behind it is to earn money and become rich. Lastly, Mother Earth might heave a sigh of relief as people will stop plundering her just so that they can see their bank balance go up. What is a jet lag? Jet lag, or desynchronosis, is a condition in which we experience symptoms like insomnia and fatigue when we travel to different time zones.
You mean when we time travel?
No, AumSum. Since the Earth rotates on its axis, different parts of the Earth experience day and night at different times, thus creating different time zones. Our body has an internal 24-hour cycle which works in sync with the time zone we live in. It is called the circadian rhythm. It tells us when to sleep and when to wake up. It also regulates hunger, body temperature, release of hormones, etc. But when we travel to a different time zone where the sun rises and sets at a different time, it disrupts our circadian rhythm. As a result, we feel disoriented and experience headache, insomnia, indigestion, etc., thus causing a jet lag. Why do we fart?
Because we like to spread some fragrance.
Ew, no. Farting or flatulence is a natural process. It involves the release of intestinal gas through anus. An average person farts about 10 to 20 times a day, and there are various reasons behind this. While eating food, we also swallow air. So, this air either comes out as burps or travels through the entire intestinal tract, and escapes as a non-smelly fart.
So, what makes some farts stink?
High-fiber foods like beans and broccoli have a sugar called raffinose. Humans lack the enzyme to digest raffinose. So, when undigested raffinose enters the large intestine, trillions of good bacteria break it down and release gases like methane, hydrogen sulfide, etc., which makes farts stinky. Some people even lack the enzyme that digests lactose. So, when these people eat cheese or ice creams, they end up releasing stinky farts. Why are gold and platinum used to make jewelry?
Wahahaha! Cause I commanded!
No. It is because gold and platinum are malleable and ductile metals. Malleability is the property by which metals can be beaten into sheets, while ductility is the property by which metals can be drawn into thin wires. These properties allow gold and platinum to be molded into a variety of designs. In addition to this, gold and platinum are very rare as well as lustrous, meaning they have a shiny appearance. These qualities make them even more attractive and enticing. Besides this, gold and platinum are noble metals. Noble metals are a group of metals which are not very reactive. that resist corrosion and oxidation. Hence, the jewelry made of gold and platinum doesn't easily lose its shine. Why do bees die when they sting us?
I don't know, but it sounds super sad.
Yeah, honeybees are the only bees that die after stinging.
Huh?
But if they die, why do they sting?
Bees only sting when they feel we are a threat to their queen or their hive. Now, the stinger of a honeybee is barbed. After stinging, it can easily come out if the skin is thin. But since human skin is thick, the barbed stinger gets stuck. Hence, when the bee tries to pull herself, she ends up tearing the abdomen, leaving behind her venom sac, parts of the digestive tract, etc., and thus killing herself. Now, although the bee is dead, we should make sure that we remove the sting. Why? Because in spite of being detached from the bee, the venom sac continues to pump venom, thus increasing the pain. Why is bird poop white?
Because they eat white chocolate.
No. Firstly, it is not the poop that is white. The green or brown part present in the center of the white portion is the actual poop of birds. Confused? The kidneys in humans extract nitrogenous waste like urea from blood and release it in the form of liquid urine. But the kidneys of birds don't produce urine. Instead, they excrete the nitrogenous waste as uric acid. This acid is the white portion. Besides this, humans have two exit points, one to remove urine produced by kidneys, and the other to remove poop produced by intestines. But birds have only one exit point, called cloaca. The poop from intestines, that is the green part, and the uric acid from kidneys are excreted at the same time, thus producing a cocktail of poop and pee. Why don't sharks have bones? Sharks belong to a special class of animals called chondrichthyes. The skeleton of these animals is not made of bones. Instead, it is made of cartilage.
What?
Cartilage is the same stuff that our ears and nose are made up of. And it is due to this material that sharks are able to skillfully maneuver in water.
But how?
Wait, I'll explain. Cartilage is less dense than bones. Hence, it is much lighter, making sharks weigh less and thus helping them stay afloat. Also, as the cartilage is flexible, it gives sharks the ability to swim quickly, catch its prey, as well as conserve energy. Besides this, studies have shown that the skeleton made of cartilage heals faster than that made of bones. So, sharks are boneless. Can puppies recognize their mothers?
I miss my mommy.
All right, stop crying. Whether a puppy recognizes its mother after a long gap or not depends on how much time the puppy spent with its mother. The period between the first 2 to 16 weeks is a very critical period of a puppy's life. During this period, the puppy imprints on its mother. This means it builds a strong bond with its mother based on sight and smell. If this happens properly, then the puppy recognizes its mother even after separation. However, the puppy won't remember the specific relation. It will just recognize her as a familiar dog because of the imprint. Since father dogs are usually unavailable during a puppy's critical period, the puppy cannot recognize its father due to lack of imprinting.
AumSum.
How can parrots talk like humans?
Cause the one and only AumSum trained them.
You wish. Birds like songbirds, hummingbirds, and parrots are vocal learners. They have defined centers called cores in their brain which control their vocal learning. However, only parrots can talk like humans. Why so? According to a research, this is because their brain is designed quite differently than songbirds and hummingbirds. In their brains, parrots have an additional structure. what scientists call shells or outer rings surrounding the cores. These shells are believed to help parrots to be really good at copying sounds, thus giving them the ability to talk like humans.
Hello.
In addition to this, parrots are highly sociable animals. As they crave interaction as well as attention, they start mimicking us to become a part of our flock.
Oh.